So how did Galileo quantify motion in two dimensions? Well, he was a good scientist, so he did an experiment. This experiment involved rolling balls off of a table and controlling the speed with which they rolled off the table and measuring where the ball landed. Galileo controlled the speed of the ball by adjusting the height from which it rolled. So if he wanted to go faster, he would roll it from higher up. We'll talk later about how exactly he could know where to put the ball. Galileo controlled the speed of the ball by adjusting where on the plane he released it from. Higher up, of course, meant it would be going faster by the time it got to the edge of the table. Like in his previous experiments, he didn't know the units of his velocity, but he knew their relative sizes. So for example, he knew he could make the velocity twice as big as it was originally, or three or four times bigger. And look what he found. Again, these are unitless distances, but look at this correspondence. When the ball had a velocity of one unit, so represented here, the trajectory looks something like this. With a velocity of two units, the ball went twice as far. Likewise with three and four units of initial horizontal velocity. You'll notice I've called this Vx. This x indicates an x direction. When we label axes, we usually call the horizontal direction x and the vertical y. And so this x is just here to remind us that we're talking about a velocity in the horizontal direction. Okay, so this is pretty interesting. So what's the conclusion that we can draw from this data? Is it that the horizontal velocity is equal to the motion in the x direction? That horizontal velocity is somehow proportional to the motion in the x direction? Or that horizontal velocity and x direction motion are totally unrelated? What's the best answer?